All right, I'm in Rishikesh on an island in the middle of the Ganga. I had to clamber over these rocks over here, find my way through with my backpack, which is my laptop on and stuff like that. I'm ready to film the intro to the vlog. There's the Ganga there, there's the Ganga there. Up there is Laxman Shula. You can't see it, it's only just down to view that connects to those two bits there. So it's closed. What we've got over there is Ram Shula. We have to walk all the way down there to get to the other side. But that's not a problem because things go much more slowly here. Slowly, slowly, slowly. Shanti, shanti. This is sacred. This is so sacred what we're doing here, where we are here. Okay, so this is, you know, people just put flags here. There are banyan trees around. And the banyan trees are sacred, so they have a heart-shaped leaf. There are many types of them. And most can survive very little water. What if you get them in mangroves? You do. So, welcome to the travel vlog. Bit of Delhi, Varanasi, Haridwar, a bit of Rishikesh. Jai Shri Ram! Jai Shri Ram! Etc. Jai Shri Ram. I procrastinated and not. And I found myself now, found myself here. We just find ourselves places, don't we? We find ourselves suddenly going off on a tangent in the space of 2 seconds, streams of consciousness. Yeah, apparently I'm ADHD. That's what I've been told. I've been told that's who I am. I don't know. But, you know, if I had advice given to me, I'd put loads of advice given to me about these vlogs, couldn't I? I could do it. So, you know what? You need to make it shorter. Shorter, snappy, more focused. But then you're missing out on the wisdom that comes to you from the ether, aren't you? You know, from the Dharma, as it were. But yeah, I'm sitting here on the Ganga. I'm actually in the middle of the Ganga. And what you can hear back there is on this holy river, this stretch of the Ganga in Rishikesh, is whitewater rafting. So for some reason or another, I don't understand the geology of it. You know, you can look into it. This stretch, there is a barrage way down beyond Haridwar. But here, there are lots of very deep, and there are currents, some shallow bits with rocks and so on. And basically, river rafting, Rishikesh, it's a big thing. And so when I'm doing this, you'll hear people going past, going, way, way, you know, on this island in the middle of Rishikesh. So what I'm going to tell you now is that I haven't vlogged for ages, for a long, long time, because I've been procrastinating. I'm in Rishikesh for 4 days, I think. I'm losing track of what day it is. I'm going to show you here, I'm losing bits and pieces, I'm going to show you here a little bit to Delhi, tiny bit, from when I came up from Goa, Varanasi, a bit of Haridwar and a bit of Rishikesh, and it goes on and on and on. So what I'm going to do now, because I know that these bits can last about 20 minutes, I'm going to tell you something about Delhi, and then I'm going to find some bits about Delhi and put that on. That'll last a very short amount of time. Might be some talking over it. I don't know. God, we wouldn't have this on the BBC, would we? Like Sue Perkins. Somebody else will be editing it for her. She'd just be going walking around. Walking around, personality being interviewed, and somebody else like makes it look good. Even though obviously she's and other treasures, you know, they're charismatic. I could do that job. Give me that job. So I won't have to edit. Oh. So first of all, Delhi. They're telling you about Delhi. You see exactly what I'm saying. Get to the point. Yeah. I arrived in Delhi. I Did I? No. Hang on. I went to Varanasi then Delhi. Yes. I got to Varanasi. It says Varanasi you'll get first. Should I just keep all that crap in? Yeah, of course it will. Yeah. Varanasi that I got to first. And I flew up there. But there was a transfer at Mumbai. It took about 4.5 hours for an incredibly long distance. I mean, it really is an incredibly long distance. The size of India compared to the UK. Huge. But you know, proportionate size of countries, relative size of countries. We could go on for hours with that. You see, there's another tangent. Yeah, apparently I'm neuro-spicy. I am spicy though. And I don't like chilies. That's a problem. I'm being happy. Chilies, that's a bit of a conundrum, isn't it? It's a bit of a puzzle. Chili does nothing for you. All it is heat. There's no real flavour in it, just heat. It's heat. It's evolved so that animals spit them out because they feel like their mouth is burning. That's what you get. So what's the motivation? My resilience to chili has built up, but that's all it is. It's resilience, so I can taste a little bit more. Nothing else. Well, I wonder if people are just after the endorphins afterwards. You know, shit, pointless. Don't get it. Can't figure it out. Answers on a postcard, please. They're postcards. Send them a postcard. Yeah, I'll give you the address. Yeah, Wood Lane. BBC Wood Lane, London. Yeah. So I didn't go to Delhi first. I went to bloody hell, like a modern funny Corbett, you know. The producer said, you know, I'm just doing this in the Ganga, aren't I? And the white water rafting in the background. Death. Before I left Goa, I met me and friend Ellie. We met this wonderful American couple, gave a tarot reading, and I said, what's some advice for my unfolding journey, my experiences, the Ganga? Pulled a card, first time I pulled this card for many, many years. Death. That's my advice, death. Should I go and interpret it? Leave that out there for now. So this is Varanasi that's coming up. I saw the Ghats. I saw the burning Ghat. I was given I was shown around it. People have burnt there. It's a huge, you know, huge deal that people are burnt on the banks of the Ganges. There are bodies covered in orange fabrics, carried through these tiny streets, had to leave out of the way. You know, Ram Ram Sachehe, Ram Ram Sachehe, shouting it. These bodies, yeah, sort of being burnt. Some people carrying the hips or the chest out of the Ganga. The hips are left for women. It's just not burnt. After 3 and something hours, and taken to the Ganga. Women are not part of these funeral rites. It's always the men that set fire to things. Depending on their relationship to the person that dies, it can be the husband, it can be the oldest son, it can be the youngest son. They have to wear white. Everything is shaven, apart from a little bit of hair at the back. Everything is clean shaven. It's burnt with mango wood for the lower caste and sandalwood for the higher caste. The highest caste Brahmin burned right at the top. What I saw, which is death, life-changing, was, I saw a body. I saw the skull. I saw the skull with the flesh still on it. I was shown around by some of the Brahmin caste. A fire has been burning there for 15 generations, at least 15 generations. That's what you say. It could be much, much, much longer. Thousands of years setting light to these pies. I went and saw the Aarti. Aarti is a ceremony of love, renunciation, forgiveness, letting things go, especially prominent, relevant, profound in Varanasi. Of course, it's all about a cycle. If somebody's burnt the shore of the Varanasi, they achieve moksha, liberation from samsara, which I'm told is different to nirvana, which of course is a Buddhist concept anyway. So that's what happened. Losing my train of thought here, of course. So they're burnt there, they're the different levels, the different castes. And what else did I do? I had a bit of a guide there. I did give him a bit of money, but not a huge amount. He repeatedly talked a lot, a huge amount, my guide, about doing things for charity, doing things for karma. A lot. He took me to a pub. I was drinking a bit there. I haven't been drinking for a while, also. It was a bar shared with rats and mice. Only men there. I bought him drink. Varanasi, it's intense, very intense. One of my most moving experiences was sitting with babas, aghori babas, or sadhus or holy men. Baba means father. They cover themselves in ash. Ash from the funeral pyres, so human ash there. I sat with them for a while, just sat. They didn't ask for anything off me, nothing. And sometimes babas ask for things off you, and we questioned the authenticity of this. Sat there for a while, and one of them looked very carefully at one of my palms. So three of them, there's photos of me with two of them, very carefully at one of my palms, very carefully examined it. Looked at it, and stared at the other one, and went, "Baba, look." And the other one looked at my palm, examined it very carefully, very carefully. All the lines. Looked amazed. Maybe they do this to a lot of people, but I doubt it. I mean, why would they? Why would they? And looked at me and went, "Baba, Baba, Baba." That was it, really. You know, and he put ash on my forehead in the funeral pyres. Walked away from that feeling a little bit bewildered. Let's give a massage. Everywhere you go, there's somebody hassling you. In Varanasi and other places. They claim they don't want to make money off you, but they do. I was given a massage, full body massage. Very aggressive one. Two men. I agreed, didn't agree to anything. They asked for lots of money. I went, no. Okay, 200, but you know, it's a very difficult thing, ethically. It's a very difficult ground to tread, ethically. And we could argue for cows come home about all these things. So, anyway, without further ado, this is supposed to be about half a minute long. You're a spicy. From an island in the Ganga. An unusually overcast day in Rishikesh. In a week or so, it's supposed to be 29 degrees. Here you go. Varanasi for you. I've just taken a tuk-tuk from the outskirts of the city, which in theory take 40 minutes. But you know, a lot of these back streets, very muddy actually, because it rained last night. It's only about 24 degrees. There's blockages, vehicles knocked over, you know, dent in the road, all sorts of things. These days it will take 10 minutes or so. So yeah. The sights, sounds, smells, cows. It's busy, busy, busy.
My tuk-tuk driver dropped me off by the river. Didn't explain why. I couldn't understand why. It looked like there were roads to where I wanted to go, but on the map, he said there wasn't. I think that's what he was saying anyway. He should know. Then he took me down to the river and they asked for 2,000 rupees, rather than £20, to go a few minutes down the river, which is insane. And then somebody with 1,000. And then there was many chaps just offered 500. So anyway, about that. But it's the Ganga, and he's swimming in it. And yeah, and by one of the many gaps, and off we go. This is Vishnu Dad's little plate. There's Vishnu over there. It's his livelihood, his business. Seems to be watertight. Highly polluted, that is, apparently. There are apparently 84 ghats within the city of Varanasi. Ghats are just places people go down to the river to wash, to bathe, to have blessings, and just to do ceremonies and rituals. There are many, many back streets in the old city of Varanasi. There are a few main roads, but this is a complete maze.
I just like recording something.
Rob from the past, where are your manners? Don't talk over you, but that's Raoul, like it's just Raoul.
God! I got this from the Burning Ghat, and it was very, 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 very eye-opening. Well, third eye-opening. But Sindhia Ghat here at the moment. How many ghats are there on the Ganga?
There are 84 ghats.
84 ghats around around Varanasi.
Yeah.
There are two sort of burning ghats. One of which is dogs, and that's either sandalwood or mango wood, depending on what you can afford and on your caste. And there's another ghat which is electric, isn't it? Apparently.
Electric fire. They are going to the accidental case more than for in this ghat, Harishchandra ghat.
Harishchandra ghat, that's one. Yeah. Okay, yeah, absolutely. It's been really, really educational and very, very intense. I've been standing next to funeral pyres, seeing the dead bodies, you know, with them half burned with the flesh still on them, the skull and things like that. So it's that's just happened. But the proximity to death reminds you of what you have to look at and you have to face, really, don't we? You have to face it.
Yeah.
It's always put part of the circle of life. And so there's lots of little subtle nuances to it, but essentially, if you're burnt on the banks of the Ganges, you achieve moksha.
Moksha is like a good heaven.
Yeah, it's good. It's good heaven from you say the samsara.
Because Varanasi is a holy city.
Mm. Yeah. To escape the samsara. Most people would be burnt here. The rituals are quite complicated. I'll go into that later on. But there are certain occasions where you wouldn't be burnt. You'd have a weight, a stone tied to you, and you go down to the bottom of the Ganges. And that's if you're a pregnant woman, a child under 10. You die from a snake bite, or if you die from leprosy.
Sadhu Baba also not burned.
Oh yes, Sadhu Babas, they don't burn either. They're already enlightened.
Yeah.
And they just put into the Ganges.
In the middle of the Ganga, he put the stones up to our body, a heavy stone,
yeah.
And make the string.
Yeah.
your all body.
Yeah.
And after he will take the boat and throw out the middle of the center of the Ganga.
Center of the Ganga. Ganga. So where do these bodies actually come up, or parts of the bodies you see when, them floating sometimes?
Because the when you know, 1 day, 2 day after, and fish was
fish eat them.
Meals.
Yeah, and parts of them come up again.
Yeah, so when you put that kind of body in the river, they have the go for to the good heaven.
Good heaven, yeah. Moksha, there you go. Which somebody was explaining to me a while ago, and I don't know the subtleties of it, although Nirvana is a Buddhist concept, it's a different thing to Nirvana, apparently, isn't it?
Varanasi.
Yeah.
Varanasi have a three names. One is Benares, mm-hmm. second is Kashi, mm-hmm. third is Varanasi. Kashi is old is gold name, because the Hindu religion know Kashi. Kashi is a main part of our Varanaras.
Right. Kashi is main part of what?
Banaras.
What's Banaras?
Banaras is the very big.
Oh, the big Varanasi, and the Kashi is the main part with all the gaps. Right. Yeah. Got you. Oh, thank you very much, mate. Yeah, so this is Shiva, also known as Raoul.
Yeah.
Right, a goat's just come to... I think this goat's only just stopped because I'm scratching her. Well, that's the only reason. I bet if I stop scratching her, she'll go, oh, no, I'll move on now. That's probably it. Yeah, this is a funny-looking dog, isn't it? Can you hear me? Oh, yep, you paused. Quite a little goat. It's amazing, I'm sort of treating her like a dog, and she's partly responding like a dog, aren't you? Yeah. So this is the arty, what I found particularly fascinating and representative of the zeitgeist is the number of phones. Look at them. See, that's it. The number of phones. Such a very recent occurrence in the vast history of eternity. But you can get these little boats there. You can hire these boats just to go right up front, which is what I did the next night. Now this is the stock of mango wood, which the lower castes are burnt with. Now what did happen next, just here, was Raoul took me to this little bar that I shared with the rats and the mice. The person behind the bar we called Mama, which didn't mean mother, because Amma means mother. He's an older bloke, 10 years older than me. Looked a lot more than 10 years older than me, subjectively. All blokes, no women allowed up there. Just not culturally right, you know. And you'll be able to see the toilet. I'll show you. You'll see it in a moment. And just here, there's a little snippet of somebody arguing about something.
गरीब नहीं है वो बहुत हरामी है वो भी क्या बोला दो सिगरेट
भैया निहाल भाई आपसे कब बोला
कि समझ में आपसे बात करना
एक चिल्लाते
हो खड़ा है ऐसे पूछ
पहला दियो यार
Here's the toilet for the men only bar. I saw a rat running up here, just up there into that hole. A few mice running around in the bar as well. There's the toilet. I'm just here in this bar. It's all men here, it's all men. There's rats and mice. And this is Raoul, also known as Shiva. He's got a different name as well. And the guy that runs it, is this guy called Mama. He's 10 years older than me.
I've been to Burningas and it's been intense. I saw a body being burned and it's like, yeah, quite gruesome. So I wish you were here, mate, because you'd love it here. Absolutely love it. Missing you. And you know, you should share this sort of thing with me. So hi Tom.
How was you, Tom?
All right, mate. He's me mate now. He's me mate.
We're
enjoying this beer. Yes, that's right. And he's my way in. He was thinking about decking someone because he touched my beard. Probably because I'm white, apparently. I stand
show
out like
public.
A sore.
He's
a public. Yeah, there we go. There we are. What's that about the backside? Where?
Take this.
Hey? Oh yeah, one of my facts. Just filming this. Hey, I'm here with Raul. Like, he introduced me to Batty Choker. I can't stop eating Batty Choker. Hey, a Batty boy. We're all going somewhere. I felt a little bit guilty he's working so hard. He took me to somewhere near the train station. So outside what's known as the Golden Temple in Varanasi. Now the famous Golden Temple is of course the Sikh one in the Punjab at Amritsar. This is a Hindu Golden Temple. Right next to it, there's actually a mosque as well, a big famous mosque. And it has this tenant before. And so things seem to be closed. There's the police here and everything as well. I'm not sure what's going on.
This is just my way to my homestay, and somebody's. Excuse me. Can I squeeze through? Excuse me. Thank you. Sorry. Wait. Sorry. Thank you. Thank you. What you want to? Okay. I guess that's for you then, is it? I'm not sure if she should eat the string. I don't know if the string's edible. It might just come out. Oh, God. I've got the height to do my son's salutations. This is my last night in Varanasi. I hired a small boat to take me out to watch the arty. But what I did see, I got a chance to film Burning Ghat from a distance, because unless you're a part of the family, you can't film anything close up. So as you can see there, we've got the Ghats burning 24 hours a day. Their bodies are happening all the time. Ram Ram Satcha Hay is what people shout as they carry the bodies through the streets. This is the...
It's
can get very, very busy. And it's around that area that the next day I was sort of accosted for sort of assaulted and made to have a full massage.
It was better from there.
The
But the arty is finished and everyone just shits off now. Everybody in all these little disperses. What are they? They're bobbing it down the... down, up the Ganges. Oh, this is Mahesh, by the way. Bye! See ya! I'm with Mahesh here, on the Ganga, the goddess of the Ganga, the animism meets polytheism, as you might say, and he's just shown us where the arty took place. This was where the arty took place. It's this ceremony, which I believe had five stages to it, is that right? Five stages?
Yes, five people doing it.
Five people doing it, and then different stages, different things.
Yeah, actually Brahmin.
They're all Brahmin, right? But there are different parts of the ceremony.
Yes.
Meaning different things right now.
Yes.
Yeah. And there's probably more lots going through there. Yeah, so they have a little game there. Oh, lots of glasses. Yeah. Right. Okay.
I, unlike me, chose to get up at 5:30, the very last morning, before I caught the train for sunrise on the Ganga.
Five past seven in the morning.
और सिख धर्म के बंधन से विमुक्त हुए गांधी जी उस अविनाशी परम पद को प्राप्त हो
So, I feel like, in a way, I've just been assaulted. Back there, a chap called Shiva, a little chap called Shiva, started massaging my hand, being friendly, you know. And then moving on to my other hand, clicking my fingers. Before I knew it, I was on the ground, both him and his son, Merhan. I don't know if it was his son. Everything, very rough. It explores every part of my body, other than my genitals. Wow. A lot of things don't expect you unexpected, really, eh? And people say, no, they say I want to do this for free, or no, but I don't know, I said, I've got any money. No, don't worry. And then they asked for 500 afterwards. But then there's respect afterwards. They would. He didn't get up at a half. It's about 8:00 in the morning. 8:00 in the morning on the banks of Ganga, Varanasi.
I'm going to go to the hospital.
These are the Aghori Babas or Sadhus. They want to transcend samsara and duality by giving up all earthly things. They're devotees of Shiva. Shiva is often referred to as the destroyer, but actually there's a little bit of ambiguity in that. Even though other gods are supposed to be creators and so on, he's creation as well. He can create, he can destroy, he can preserve, like Vishnu. Now, the Aghori Babas, they greeted me. I sat with them for quite some time, and one of the Aghori Babas put ash on me. Ash that's from the funeral pyres, the actual dead bodies. They examined my palm for quite a while. They looked at each other and they said, Baba, Baba, pointed at me and said, Baba as well. It's a little confusing, really, as to what to do with that information, but I just sort of sat with it and allowed. Baba in that context, literally it means father, but actually in that context it means wise man who has lived a long time, many rebirths and so on. I didn't mention, did I, that I got the train from Varanasi to Delhi. It was a chair car that I got, and it cost £24. It was an 8-hour journey. Meals were included, two meals were included. And that was a bit more expensive because I had to queue up at the train station. It was a long journey to the train station. I could have got it online. I didn't, because I did not have an Indian bank account. Now, I could have got my friend Raoul to do it for me. I didn't think of that until afterwards. I queued, and they told me, no, you've got the wrong window. You've got to go to that one over there, but fill in this form, which I didn't understand how to fill in. But I filled in the form. It took me quite some time. I had to go and buy a pen, find a stall to buy a pen. And I normally carry on with me. And then I queued again. I checked with the person next to me if I filled this incorrectly. Luckily, I had a photo of my passport on my phone because I needed that as well. And I got that. So the advice is, if you're going to book a train ticket, you need to get an Indian friend who can pay for it quickly and easily, and you give them cash. And it's often a bit cheaper as well. This is chair car. Chair car was, I wish I filmed it. I really should have. I thought, what was wrong with me? So it's quite comfortable, really. This was an express train, hasn't had two stops, and it's more luxurious and newer than most Indian trains. And that was to Delhi. I stayed in Delhi for one night, and again, it's a right to do trying to find my hotel near the train station. I got there eventually. It was a very basic hotel. In fact, I'm going to be able to show you a little snippet of what the hotel looked like, I think. So it was quite a comfortable journey. I arrived rather late, and then the next day I was late for my bus from Delhi. So I had to wait around the bus terminal for about 2.5 hours. This is a very posed photo. I like to call this one, like the internet viral one, life feels so much easier and better once you've had a big poo. I sent this photo to a friend of mine, Tom, and he said something poetic, like, the world is the weight of a butterfly once you've dropped a big stool, something like that. Yeah, so yes, it was a lovely journey. And then I eventually got to Haridwar. They dropped me off somewhere near the hotel that I booked, and it was kind of like in the middle of nowhere, really late at night. I asked them to drop me off there. I jumped off, and then I lost my lovely hat again, my second hat that I lost. My mum sent me this one through the post, actually, some time ago. But there you go, another exercise in non-attachment.
I am, after all, getting to the Haridwar more Ganga. Kind of getting used to it, really.
Hello.